Now, today we study some examples which are based on some properties which we are on here previous period. Yeah, these examples are here present in the form of activity base. Yeah, as I got here, on activity base, one example as I got here, we are here asked in the figure. AB parallel CD parallel EF. If AC is equal to 5.4, CE is equal to 9, BD is equal to 7.5, then find DF. Figure here as I have line AB parallel line CD parallel line EF and line B and Q are transversals of that three parallel lines. For solution, as I have in figure AB parallel CD parallel EF. By using the property of three parallel lines and their transversal, we get here equation and like AC upon a empty box is equal to empty box upon DF. Here is the dash dash. 6.4 upon 9 is equal to empty box upon DF, then DF is equal to empty box. We are here fill these empty boxes by correct statement or your correct answer are here. And then are here in exam also, we are here counting this box correctly. When we are here write only answer, we not get box and your answer are here wrong. Remember, all students is fine for board notification. Board exam notification as I got it. Therefore, solution we get are here. Yeah, line AB parallel line CD parallel line EF and line B and Q are transversal. Therefore, by using the property of three parallel lines and their transversal, we know the property of three parallel lines and their transversal. When the ratio of intercept made on any one transversal by three parallel lines is equal to the corresponding ratio of intercept made on another transversal by same parallel line. Therefore, by using this property, we get the equation that AC upon CE is equal to BD upon DF. Therefore, in first empty box, you write here CE is equal to another empty box, we get here BD. Therefore, BD. And here we get these two ratio are the same. Reason is here by property of three parallel lines and their transversal. Three parallel line and their transversal. This is the reason of that equation. And then I have report the given value. Here AC is we are here given here 5.4. And therefore we write our AC in 5.4. And then CE is 9 is equal to here BD. What are your BD is 7.5. Therefore write our 7.5 upon BF. BF is 9. And then by calculation, we take our rough calculation on rough page. Means as I got this rough calculation, Suppose I have a take of calculation and like I have to take cross multiplication. 5.4 into P is equal to 7.5 into 9. Then we have to get VF is equal to VF is equal to 7.5 into 9 upon is 5.4 present in multiple part on this side. Then transfer on this side, then we have in division form, therefore we are here right divided by 5.4. And then I have in numerical place, in this number, after 0.1 millivalue present, in denominator place, in this number, after 0.1 millivalue present, therefore we only neglect that point because if digit number are here same, and therefore here 75 into 9 upon 54. This is the value of the year. Then are here we divide this 54 by 9, and then are here we get here 9 into 6, then we get 54, and then are here divide 75 by 6, then are here we get 6 divided by 7 by 6, then I will get 1. Here again, 6 into 1, 6. 7 minus 6, 1. Here it means, here this number 15. Again, I will divide this 15 by 6. Then we get, here, 6 into 2, we get area 12. This value is greater than 15, therefore, here we get 2. And then I will 15 minus 12. We take here 0 on this 3, here we get 0.0, and here 6 into 5, we get here 30, therefore 12.5. Like other, we get value of here is 12.5. Put this value in this empty box. Like other, by using here this property, we solve this activity. Here, activity. Understand and remember all this activity. How you have solved this activity? Here, as I have. Then I have another example, another property. Here, this example is also present on activity base. Here, in this example, here we give up. Figure E and line. Activity second. In this activity second, we are here given, figure is, and like other, we are here given one triangle. That triangle is ABC. In this triangle ABC, we are here given angle bisector of angle ABC. That angle bisector of angle ABC intersect side AC in point D, and then are here these two angles are here common. Then we are here given here this segment, here intersect of this line intersect side AB in point here E. And like earlier, here are here given, and activity are given as like earlier. In triangle ABC, ray BD, ray BD is an angle bisector, is an angle bisector of angle ABC. sin de e again we are going to give sin de parallel sin this and then prove that then prove that yeah AD upon BC. Here we are here proof. Here AB upon BC. AB upon BC is equal to AE upon AE upon AB. And then here we are here given solution. In triangle ABC, solution are here present in the form of 2 pi r. Therefore, solution means are here. For this example, this are here 2. And then are here, we are here given in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, ray BD is an angle. Bisector angle bisector of an angle ABC of an angle ABC. Therefore, here by angle bisector theorem or a theorem of an angle bisector of a triangle. We get here AB upon BC is equal to AB upon DC. Here we note this equation number first. Reason is just by angle bisector theorem. Or here theorem of an angle. Bisector, angle bisector of a triangle. In triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, BE parallel side BC. BE parallel side BC. Therefore, we get here AE upon here AB is equal to AD upon DC. You know this equation number second. Result is here by basic proportionality theorem. By basic proportionality theorem. Then, by equation first and second, we have new relation. That new relation is as like a here. AB upon empty box is equal to empty box upon AB. Result by equation first and second. By equation first and second. Now here in this two empty box, how you fit these two empty box? Now see here carefully are here as like I do. Yeah, in here in triangle ABC we are here given ray AD is an angle bisector of angle ABC. Therefore, by bisector theorem of an angle of a triangle, we get AB upon BC is equal to AD upon BC. You know this equation number 4 is the theorem of an angle bisector of a triangle. Also in this figure, in triangle ABC, DE parallel side BC. Therefore, by using BPT, we get equation AE upon EB is equal to AD upon BC. Do not miss equation number 2. And these are your five basic proportionality theorem. And here we see these two equations. By these two equations, we get new equation, because here in these two equations, RHS are same, therefore LHS is same. We get AB upon BC is equal to here AE upon EB. Therefore, in this first box, we get here BC, and another box here we get AE. As I like to keep these empty boxes correctly. All students, remember this activity. And then we solve some examples which are given in practice set 1.2, and another example are solved. All students here in your home, this is homework to all our students. Some examples in this practice set 1.2 we are studying.
P U R
Yeah, this PM, red PM, is a P1 airplane. Red PM, is P1 airplane. Here, enter say you are in point. And here we want some segment length. That segment length 3.5. Yeah. Then yeah, that segment 1.5. That segment 7. That segment 3. And then we are identifying right here is an angle bisector of angle QPR. Yes or yes? No. But earlier we not answer given in yes no type. We solve this example. This example I will solve and then solution. In here, in triangle PQR. PQ upon PR is equal to 7 point upon P. You know this equation number first. With an area given. Because this value area given. Here QP is 7, here is P. And then area we get another ratio. That ratio is as like area QM upon MR. Therefore, QM upon MR. And then area QM is 3.5 upon MR is 1.5. And then, we first of all find value of this area. In this equation, after 0.1 degree area present in numerator place and in denominator place, after 0.1 digit are present. This number of digits are your same after point, therefore only we neglect this point. And then earlier we get value of this ratio as like earlier. QM upon PR, QM upon MR is equal to 30.2 upon 15. And then earlier divide both the number by the 5, and then I will be at 5 into 3, 15, and 5 into 7, 35. Therefore, lastly, we get 7 upon 3. You know this equation number 7. Result is here, E1. This value is E1. In figure. Earlier, by figure. E1 in figure. Given in given. And then earlier, by equation first and second, arranges of both the equation on your same. We get in first equation, PQ upon PR is equal to 7 upon 3. In second equation, we get QM upon MR is equal to also 7 upon 3. Therefore, arranges of both the equation are same. Then we get arranges is also same. Lastly, we get PQ upon PR is equal to QM upon MR. And then after PQ upon PR is equal to QM upon MR, then formulas of angle bisector theorem upon an angle upon triangle, we get ray PM is an angle bisector of angle QPR. Therefore, by converse of theorem of an angle bisector upon triangle, Vegan. Lastly, vegan. Yeah. Therefore, Re-ya. Is an angle bisector. Angle bisector or angle 2BR. As I decide, radio is an angle bisector of angle 2BR. Yes or no? Therefore, here radio is the angle bisector of angle 2BR. Because reason is the converse of theorem of angle bisector of a triangle. And then here another figure, second figure is given as that. All students remember how to solve this example. This example we solve as that. We are here practice of this solve example which are here solved in class. I know. Then are here second figure. In second figure, the second figure is given and like are here. We are here given and triangle B to R. Here B, here Q, here R. And then are here one ray PM intersect side RQ in point PM and some lengths of sides are given, segments are here given. This length are C, this length are A, this is 10 and this is 7. And here how to decide, and here how to identify the ray PM is the bisector of angle 2PR, yes or no? But earlier we not write this answer in yes no time. We solve this example. About this example earlier solve, earlier we decide as like earlier by using solution as like earlier in figure, in triangle. In figure, in triangle PQR, we tell the ratio of the two sides here PQ upon PR, PQ upon PR is equal to 10 upon 7, 10 upon 7, you know this equation number first. We tell another ratio. And I got UM upon YAMAR. UM upon YAMAR. Of that two sides. And then are you put the value of that sides which are given in figure. Here A upon 6. Just simplify this ratio. Then are you B A. Lastly, you have both the number. Y. Here 2, then I will get 2 into 3, 6, 2 into 4, 8. Lastly, we get 4, 5, 3. We know this equation number 2. And by this equation first and second, our relations are not same. Means we get new relation. 10 upon 7 is not equal to 4 upon 3. 4 by 3. Therefore, by equation first and second, by equation first and second, here value of here 10 by 7 in equation first is PQ upon PR. Put this value here. PQ upon PR is not equal to in equation second. Which are given here we get QM upon YAMAR. And where are then by converse of angle bisector, converse of theorem of angle bisector of a triangle, a ray PM is not a angle bisector of an angle QPR. Therefore, by converse of and theorem of angle bisector of angle bisector of a triangle ray PM is not a angle bisector of angle QPR. Whether you have resolved your this example or your identity ray PM is the bisector of angle QPR or not a bisector of angle QPR. In for this figure, ray PM is not a angle bisector of angle QPR by converse of theorem of angle bisector of a triangle. All students remember how to identify the given ray which are the angle bisector of given angle or not. All students remember and practice this exam. Solve this all exam for all your 2 times and then I will remember which property are here used. Now all students are yes. Now next example in practice set 1.2, which are in place of some property where you learn. In this example 3, where you are given in the figure, x is at any point in the interior of triangle, then point x is joined to vertices of triangle. Segment PQ parallel segment BE, segment QR parallel segment PR. Fill in the blanks to prove that segment PR parallel segment PR. Now read this example carefully and here now observe your figure and by using by any one property which are we to learn we fill this plan box empty boxes by using this property. Now in row where you are given in triangle XDP, triangle XDE, XDE, your PQ parallel D, PQ parallel D. We see this triangle XDE. In this triangle, your line PQ is parallel to side E and intersect another 2 sides in 2 distinct points. Therefore, by basic propositionality theorem, we get equation XP upon PD. Therefore, in first empty box, we get XP, here XP upon PD. Therefore, here we write PD is equal to here XQ upon QE. Therefore, in this empty box, we write XQ. And here, we saw here, we are here, V1. And then either this is the equation for either either by basic propositionality theorem. Also in figure, in triangle XEF, we see triangle XEF. In this triangle, we are here given QR parallel EF. This are here given in example. Therefore, here is an idea. preparing this empty box and the yard. And then I am playing in triangle X, E, here. Here you are parallel side here. Intersect side XC and side XL in two distinct points U, R, U and R. Then by basic probability theorem, we get a relation is here as I have here X cube upon U E. X cube upon U E is equal to XR upon R. As I have here, we get this relation. And this are here, we get here by here V1. Therefore, we got this equation second and reason are here by basic proportionality means are here. We get R here, X cube upon U E is equal to X R upon R. Therefore, here we get, here we prove that here we are parallel segment B here. Therefore, in this here two triangles, here triangle X B E and triangle X E here, we get these two equations, then here we get a new equation by that three equation is here as I have here xp upon pd is equal to xq upon qe is equal to xr upon rf. Then we are here we get xr upon rf is equal to xp upon pd. Therefore, by equation first and second, we get new relation xr upon rf is equal to xp upon pd. And then our in triangle here xr upon rf in triangle XD here, XR upon RF is equal to XP upon PD. Then RF, by converse of basic proportionality theorem, we get here segment PR parallel side D here. Therefore, in triangle XD here, we get here segment PR parallel side DR by converse of BPD basic proportionality theorem. As like we prove here this example or here this statement. Therefore, in triangle XFD, we get PR parallel D here. All students remember this example which are here present on activity guides, how to solve. Practice this example. Repeat here one or here two times or here. We are here when we are here understand. After you understand.